talk about it this morning is clinical nutritionist Krista Arecchio of The Whole Journey. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
So I think most people know what it is, but for those who don't, what exactly is farm to table and what are some of the benefits?
It's just a really simple concept where we're going back to basics of taking food from the farm to the table and bypassing the grocery store.
So if we can switch to organic products, we have a better chance of getting higher amount of nutrition into our kids' diet.
For those of you that are still really resistant and you're not gonna buy organic, make this $1.50 fruit and veggie wash and at least it'll be 50% better.
Okay.
But I wanna impart, you know, the philosophy, either pay now or pay later.
We're filling ourselves with nitrates and hormones and antibiotics, and nitrates raise blood pressure.
Soy is, it's one of the most subsidized genetically modified crops, so yes, it's creeped its way into every part of our diet pretty much. So it's really important to know where you get it.
We don't have as many minerals in our soil or in our water as we used to. So for example, Erica, I was telling you, you have to eat 3 apples today to get the nutrient value of 1 apple in 1940. If your digestion isn't working, nothing else is gonna work. Your immune system won't function, your hormones won't be balanced, and 1 in 5 people have digestive issues.
So the first step is to tenderize the leaves. What I have here is a mixture of olive oil and Celtic sea salt. And so I'm just gonna dip my fingers in here and just massage the leaf of the kale.
What are the basics, some of the basic things we need to do to keep from gaining the weight this holiday season?
Okay, so the first thing that we can do is to start using low glycemic sweeteners and low glycemic flours in your holiday baking. Okay, now I'm a holistic health counselor and a nutritionist, so it's about staying healthy and weight is a byproduct of that.
Organs are developing. You don't want them eating a food that doesn't work well with their system every single day. It's better to know. The 5 most common food allergies are wheat, dairy, corn, soy, and eggs.
Everybody should try it if you have stomach issues, skin issues, autoimmune issues, anything like that.
We are here at the Spice Hunter. Do you think about which spices you buy and the quality of those? I think that might be something that people maybe falls to the wayside.
So tell me, how can foods help make you happier?
Foods can make you happier in so many different ways. And one thing that I always talk about in my practice is the connection between digestion and mental health. And so what you eat is so important because we produce 80% of serotonin, the feel-good neurotransmitter, in our guts.
Most of America is dealing with yo-yo dieting and all the trends that are out there. And our philosophy is natural weight loss.
Okay.
And what does that actually mean?
Yeah, what does that mean?
And the idea is working with the body instead of against it. So much of dietary philosophy is trying to trick the body into doing what you want it to do.
Okay.
But that doesn't really pay any respect to the infinite wisdom that the body has. So our whole philosophy is approaching weight loss by simultaneously getting rid of toxins, getting rid of excess, and then filling in nutritional deficiencies to balance and strengthen the organs and glands.
They will have 50 to 70 more chemicals. That means your liver is working overtime if you're gonna eat these conventionally grown.
Okay.
I must say, without a doubt, all animal meats and eggs should be organic.